Turning now to yet another major security breach at one of America's largest retailers, this time at Home Depot. What went wrong and why can't hackers be stopped? For more, we're joined now by Mike Riley. He's a reporter with Bloomberg. So we heard reports about this hack a couple of weeks ago. What happened to Home Depot?
So it wasn't that different than what happened to Target. Basically, the hackers got into the network and were able to use Home Depot's own system to put malware on each of the registers. So basically, when you went into Home Depot, swiped your card, they were stealing the card almost as quickly as Home Depot was getting it.
I mean, after seeing what happened to Target, I mean, this is a company that has almost $80 billion in revenue, 2,000-plus stores in the U.S. Didn't they learn from it?
Yeah, I mean, that's the thing. It's like, it's one thing to be Target and watch this happen in a relatively new kind of attack. It's another thing to be Home Depot, watch Target get taken down, watch them lose 40 million credit cards, not learn, or at least not learn enough to act quickly so that it doesn't happen to you. Retailers generally don't have great security, and Home Depot didn't seem to take the steps quickly enough anyway. In one case, they bought an encryption system to encrypt the data from the register, so even if the hackers had stolen it, but they just didn't install it until about 6-7 days ago.
Oh, well, compare this to the rest of the world. We don't necessarily hear about these hacking things happening, let's say, in Europe or Asia nearly as much.
Yeah, the difference is that Europe and Asia, just about any advanced economy, uses credit cards with a chip in it. And the funny thing about the chip, it doesn't make it harder to steal the data. It makes it harder to make money from the data. Basically, what the chip in the card does, the way the ecosystem works is you steal the credit cards, you sell them to people, they buy the cards, create a fake card, go into Best Buy, buy a giant TV, right, whatever it is. But it's much harder to create a fake card if it's got a chip in it. So anything that's got a chip in it just makes it harder for thieves to make money off of the data.
And so, you know, this is also in a climate where the consumers are getting a bit fed up, just saying, where did my credit card get used? And then what was that store that got hacked? And how do I keep track of all this?
It's just one hack after the next. And I think I think one of the things we saw in Target is it was a Christmas season hack and customers just stopped going to the stores. Now, I don't know if that's going to happen to Home Depot. It may be that they handled it differently. It may be that it's just a different kind of customer. But I think generally retail brands are taking hits because they're not protecting consumers' data. It's something that you walk into a store, you buy something, you expect the store to protect your data. That clearly isn't happening.
Now, this we are in a different point in the evolution of how we transact business. I mean,
right,
credit cards kind of came around saying, hey, it's so much more secure than walking around with big bods of cash.
Absolutely.
Right? And then now the cards seem to be getting replaced by our phones with NFC or other technologies, maybe the Apple Pay thing. I mean, how quickly is the U.S. moving towards kind of digital currencies or maybe even just putting those chips in the cards?
So next year, basically, the U.S. is scheduled to start to catch up with the rest of the world and transition to basically a chip system in their credit cards. The banks and the retailers have gotten together and said, look, we're going to set October of next year, 2015, as a deadline where liability will shift to whichever side of the equation doesn't allow the chip transaction. So it's if retailers don't have the readers in their stores that can read the chips and they get hacked, the liability is on them. If banks don't put the chips in their card and the retailer gets hacked, the liability is on them. It's going to create a lot of incentive to shift over. And that could explain what's going on now. This seems to be kind of a feeding frenzy. You're seeing a lot of retail hacks. Might be that that they see this as their last opportunity before this transition starts
and
to take place.
And in the process, you've got people that are victims of identity theft, which
right,
is kind of the worst case, not just a credit card loss.
Right. It's not the credit card numbers are not the only data that these guys are stealing. In the case of Target, for example, they took a lot of personal data as well, names, addresses, a lot of things that these retailers store up. Target was really good at targeting specific kinds of sales and merchandising ads to their customers, but all that is based on a huge amount of data that they collect from their customers as they move around the stores, as they swipe their cards, as they send them stuff, and all of that is in their databases. So the hackers can, even if they can't get the cards, they can steal that.
All right, Michael Riley of Bloomberg, thanks so much.
You bet.